Did you know that you can integrate Jotform with Google Sheets? Well, let me show you how. Hey Jotformers, welcome back. I'm Kimberly, and like I mentioned, if you use Google Sheets, you can absolutely send your Jotform form submissions to that sheet. So as you can see, I'm currently in my desktop on my workspace. And as of right now, under type, I am only viewing my forms. So for this example, I'm going to use my AI agent's help form. So let's go ahead and edit our form. And this form is very simple. We have name, email, phone number, description of the problem that they're having or what they need help with. And then we also have a file upload option. So for this, we're gonna come up to the top, up to settings, and on the left-hand side, we're gonna go over to integrations, and we can do a quick search for Google Sheets, but I can see it is right here at the top, so I'm gonna go ahead and choose Google Sheets. Now from here, we have two different options. We can either have this create a brand new spreadsheet, or we can use an existing spreadsheet that we have already created outside of Jotform. I haven't created anything as of right now, so I'm gonna choose that first one to create a new spreadsheet. So let's go ahead and choose next. You can choose your account that you would like to work with. I'm going to go ahead and use my Jotform one, so let's go ahead and authenticate. All right, so we can see here, this is what the spreadsheet is going to be named. So if you want to change this to something else, here is your time to do that. Next, we have the worksheet name. We have form responses. Again, if you want to change that, you can. Next, we have the form fields to be sent to Google Sheets. So we have first name, last name, email, everything that we had. If we want to add in any of the submission information, like the edit URL, the edit date, the submission date, the submission IP, you can add those in as well. And we want to send existing submissions to the sheet. We can do that. I already have a few on here that we can go ahead and send. If you prefer to start from scratch from here on out, you can go ahead and uncheck this. So one thing to keep in mind, if after we've created this, if you end up changing the name of your spreadsheet, if you end up changing the name of the worksheet, if you end up filtering while someone is filling out a form and sending that data, it is possible that this integration can break. So make sure that before we set everything up, that these match how you want it to be. And if you end up making changes to your Google Sheet, we come over here and we make those same changes here to keep that integration going. So let's go ahead and save. All right, we can see right here we have that spreadsheet. Now, if we need to come in here and do any edits, this is where we can do that. Right here, we can choose the three dots. We can see the action logs. We can see the things that are happening or if there are any errors that happen. We can rename the action and we can disable or delete from here as well. So I'm gonna go ahead and click here to open up that spreadsheet. Perfect. So we can see that we had a couple that have already gone through. We have that file upload as well. We see here AI agents help. And then down here, the form responses is the name of that tab. So let's go ahead and preview our form. And let's do fill form again. And I'm just going to leave this as text box sample just for this example. And we'll upload one more time. All right, let's do submit. All right, we're good to go. Let's head back over to our sheet. And I didn't even have to refresh the sheet. It automatically goes in. And it really is as simple as that. If you have any questions about how to integrate your Jotform with Google Sheets, let us know down below in the comments. If you like this video and you got some value, hit that like button and don't forget to subscribe and turn on the bell so you get a notification every time we put out a new video. I'll see you next time.